Hey everyone, this is Some Nerdy Guy back again with another video. I was not expecting to do another pickups video so soon, but a friend of mine online, he goes by Barnacle, but his name is Noah. He gave me a bunch of Sega Genesis stuff. He just outright gave it to me. We had planned on meeting up, and I was going to get a couple of things off of him and whatnot, and it just like never happened. And then one night our whole friend group got together. It had been months since we had seen each other. We all got together and blah blah blah, and I had asked him about it and how much he wanted for him, and he just ended up giving them to me. So thank you so much, Noah. I really appreciate it, man. It was very generous of you to just give this stuff to me, and it has definitely gone to a good home. I definitely want to play a majority of these. If anything, some of them I might not get around to for a while, which I know he understands. I mean, everybody has backlog and stuff like that. So, but without further ado, I'm just going to get into it. There's a couple, or there's two boxed things, and one's a 64 game actually, and not a Genesis game. So I guess I'll get that one out of the way first. And that is Turok 2 Seeds of Evil for the Nintendo 64, complete in the box. So I thought that was really awesome. I've been trying to slowly gain a collection of complete in box 64 games. I have like four or five of them at the moment, so this is definitely a good addition. See, you can kind of see there's the insert. Oh, whoa. There was the manual, there's the cartridge there, and it still has like cardboard insert and everything. So this was really cool. Super excited about that one. The only box game here, still really cool, and I also have it complete in box on the Super Nintendo, so it's kind of cool to get both the Genesis and the Super Nintendo version, and that is Ms. Pac-Man. So only paid $3 for that, but that's really cool. Yay. And then this is the other box thing. It's just the box, didn't come with the thing itself, but that's all right because I have one, obviously, if I already have a console. And that is a Genesis controller box. So, yeah, just the box. But, you know, it's cool for display because, you know, you just put it all back together like so and just kind of have it sitting on your shelf. Genesis box. So, I'm more than happy with that. I mean, how could I not be happy? Somebody was nice enough to just give this stuff to me, of course. And I'm going to be happy with anything. And I'm also very easily amused, so. This game, I think I already have this one, so I might gift this to another friend. That is Pac-Man 2, The New Adventures. So there's that one. This game was always like super weird to me. It was kind of a platformer, but also like a puzzle game from what I remember. Almost like a point-and-click adventure game kind of thing. So, yeah, there's that one. This is probably the best, if not one of the best, games in this entire lot. And that is Comic Zone. I was really excited to have this one. I remember playing it on the Sonic Genesis Collection thing on the Xbox 360 back in the day. And this game got pretty pricey. I think, I mean, obviously complete in box is more expensive, but even the cartridge is over 20 bucks, I think. So this one is really cool. I'm super excited to have this one. The label is coming up a little bit, but that's not really a big deal because it's just for being played. This game, already have it. Unfortunately, so I'll probably gift this one to someone else as well. Sonic 2. I already have a complete one. I don't want to sound like, oh, I already have it, I don't want it. But, like, I don't know. Like, when you're collecting games, sometimes you get stuff you already have. Nothing wrong with that. Some people like having doubles. I probably will just gift these to someone else just to kind of, you know, pay it forward. I was trying to think of the words, but yeah, pay it forward. This game, I don't think I have, but I also probably will either buy a box for it or just get a complete box copy. That is Columns. It's like one of the most classic Genesis games right there. The next one is a movie game, and there's a new movie of it coming out next month, I believe, and that is Jurassic Park. Got the new Jurassic World movie coming out, so it's a cool little... from what I remember, I think I watched like AVGN or something that the Jurassic Park game is not great, but I've never played it, so make my own opinion about it. I'll play it myself. And then, sorry, this is going to be pretty quick, honestly, because I just got these, so I have not played any of them yet. At least the ones that I've haven't played before. Like some of these are games I've definitely played before. The next one is another movie game. It's a Disney one, and I believe this is on the Switch. They put this on the Switch and the PS4, excuse me, with two other games, and that is The Lion King. I think they did it with, yeah, it was the Aladdin game and the Jungle Book game, I think. And then they have Lion King with that. So that's pretty cool. Can't complain. This one's kind of a heavy cartridge. Like some of these are really light, but this one's got some heft to it, which is interesting. This one is another game that I do already have. So again, I'll probably gift this to someone else. And I don't think I have the sequel. I think I only have the first game. But it's really fun. It's an action platforming game. And that is Vector Man. Vector Man is a super good Genesis game. Very, I this is one of the games that I always think about when I think, besides like Sonic, when you think about Sega, this is like one of the other mascot type characters that I always think about is Vector Man. And I always liked the opening, like the title screen. No, it's like right before the title screen. It shows Sega and like Vector Man like falls down and you can actually play on that screen with just the Sega logo on it. I thought that was really cool. So, yeah, Vector Man. And then this next game, I have not played actually, but I definitely will because it's got characters I like in it, and my favorite superhero. For those of you who know me, you already know who that is. But I have not played a lot of the older games from like different superheroes, like the Captain America games on the NES or the X-Men games. I played like the X-Men arcade game and stuff like that. But a lot of the older games I haven't played. Trying to think of any of the ones I have. Not a Marvel game, but DC. I've played like the Batman Michael Keaton game on the NES. I've played that. But yeah, most of the superhero games I have played are more modern ones. Like, of course, the Spider-Man PS4 game or like Spider-Man 2 on PS2 or Ultimate Spider-Man. And that kind of gives it away. It's a Spider-Man game, but it's Spider-Man and the X-Men Arcade's Revenge. Or wait, this one's. Yeah, Arcade's Revenge. It's weird. They don't have it. Oh, it's like. Sorry. I'm just like sitting here looking at it. But like. Ooh, nice catch. On the label up here, it has, you know, Spider-Man and the X-Men. But on here, or well, it says Arcade's Revenge on there or whatever. But on here, it just says Spider-Man and X-Men. And then really tiny right here, it says Arcade's Revenge. It's not like part of the actual title, it's just kind of right there. Which I think is a little strange, but you know, whatever. I'm going through these pretty quickly. This is probably going to be a pretty short video. I just didn't want to tack this on to another pickup video. I kind of wanted it to be its own thing because there's kind of a decent amount of stuff here. And if I added it on to another video, it'd probably make the length of it longer than my videos usually are, which are already kind of long. This game, I don't think I've ever heard of, and I didn't look up any gameplay of it. But just by looking at it, looks just like a 2D platformer, typical kind of 90s thing that they did a lot. It was just make different mascots and different characters because of how well Mario and Sonic were doing, which there's nothing wrong with that. There's some cool characters that came out of that. But this one, I'm not so sure of. I don't know if it's good, don't know if it's bad, but that is Pugsy. He's a little orange, reddish blob guy with sunglasses. He's got his little sunglasses. He's got little droopy eyes. He looks really tired or sad. I don't know what's really wrong with him. There's a dragon. There's a parrot with a musket. That's pretty cool. I like birds. And then the title is done in Comic Sans, so that's kind of funny. The font that they use. But yeah, like I said, I don't really know a whole lot about this game. Oh, the screws are coming out of this one. I have to put those back in. But yeah, I don't really know much about this one. Like I said, assuming it's a 2D platforming game. Judging by just the art alone and the Comic Sans font, it's probably not like best one, but who knows? It could be worth playing. I'll find out eventually. And then this one I saved for last because this one is my favorite out of all the ones I've got here. I was gonna buy this game a while ago, which I might still buy it because I would like to have a complete box copy of it, but getting it a cartridge for free, I can't complain about that because I almost did buy the cartridge by itself because I didn't think I'd ever find a complete box one. But this game is definitely very, it's very interesting in terms of like how you played it and what you had to do. I mean, you don't have to, but like what you could do with it, because it was like, it was almost like an add-on, but it was a game. So it was like, I don't know. I'm trying to like describe it before I show it, so I probably might as well just show it. That is Sonic and Knuckles. So like it was an attachment, it was an add-on for a game. You like flip this little thing open and you put your Sonic 3 cartridge in there, and then you have Sonic 3 and Knuckles, and then from my understanding, because I've never played the cartridge version, I just played it on like Sonic Mega Collection and all that. So I'm assuming like you can play it just this, and it's its own game, or you add the Sonic 3 cartridge, and I think it puts Knuckles in Sonic 3 or something like that. I can't remember exactly how it went, but yeah, I thought this was the best one because I didn't have it already. This was, I mean, obviously a lot of these games I didn't have already. But this was one I was really excited about because it's one I definitely wanted for my own collection for a while. That and Comic Zone, these are like the two big ones that I was really super excited about. So very happy with those. Like I said, the other ones, some of the ones that I have doubles of, I'll probably just re-gift them to someone else. My friend Mike has a Genesis now. He bought it for his dad, I believe. And I don't know, just give him a couple games to play on it. And then again, I'm super excited about Turok 2. Because I've been wanting to get more into Complete Box 64 games. These are definitely games that I've bought in very few and far between. Like I said, I only have like five of them. But if I find them for a good enough price, I've been trying to get some. I definitely want to get like all the Marios, like the Mario Party, and I have Mario 64 in the box and stuff like that. But Mario Golf, Tennis, all that stuff. And then the Zeldas, I have Ocarina, but I don't have Majora's Mask. You know, all the typical Nintendo ones I would like to have complete in the box, like the first party games and all that. But anyways, that was a quick little pickup video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you like Genesis, let me know what your favorite Genesis game is. That'd be kind of cool. I don't know. There's a lot of them, a lot of different Genesis games, and I've only ever played a handful of them. So it'd be nice or kind of cool to see what other people liked to play on the Genesis. Me personally, obviously Sonic games I liked a lot. I liked Gunstar Heroes, Vector Man, of course, The Ooze. The Ooze was definitely a unique one. I used to have it on like a Genesis plug and play thing, so that's how I played it. And any of the Phantasy Star games, those I've only played on like the Sonic Genesis Collection because those are really expensive. But those and like Beyond Oasis, I think, is the one of the Oasis games. But anyways, I've only played really a handful. I want to get more into playing Genesis because I think it's still a cool console. I just don't have a whole lot of games for it, so now I have some more to play, so it's cool. And I got them for nothing, so I can't really complain about that. So again, thank you, Noah, or Barnacle, whichever one you'd rather go by. And yeah, I'll probably do another video later this week. And until then, see you.